Welcome to e-learning course on Applied Thermodynamics, Module Gas Power Cycle, Session Jet Propulsion. Myself, Ramesh B.R., Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. Jet Propulsion Cycle. All the phenomena of propulsion devices are based on Newton's second law and third law of motion. The principle of jet propulsion involves imparting momentum to a mass of fluid in such a manner that the reaction of imparted momentum provides a propulsive force which makes an object to move in the required direction. It may be achieved by expanding the gas which is at high temperature and pressure through a nozzle, due to which high velocity of jet of hot gases is produced that gives a propulsive force in opposite direction due to its reaction. For jet propulsion, the open cycle gas turbine is most suitable. Further, we see some of the classifications of propulsion systems. Normally, they are classified based on two cases or two categories. One is air breathing engines, another one is non-air breathing engines. Air breathing engines are further categorized as, before moving on to the categories, so we see what is meant by air breathing engine. So these are the reciprocating engines or gas turbines which use atmospheric air for propulsion purposes, and non-air breathing engines will make a combination of liquid or solid propellants and carry their own supply of oxidants. And air breathing engines are classified as two cases: steady combustion system or continuous airflow system, and the second one is intermittent combustion system or intermittent flow system. And non-air breathing engines are of two types: liquid propellant or solid propellant. And steady flow combustion system is also classified or having three different types. One is turbojet, turboprop and ramjet, and intermittent combustion system have pulse jet or flying bomb type. So these are the few classifications based on the principal phenomena of propulsion devices. Now we see one by one. The first one is turbojet. So the line diagram is going to represent the construction of a turbojet. So the figure shows a turbojet. It consists of a diffuser at the entrance. So we can also make out in the pictorial represent of the same figure. In the front of this turbojet, we are going to have a diffuser which slows down the air entering at velocity equal to the aircraft speed. And a part of the kinetic energy of the air stream is converted into pressure, and this type of compression is called as ram compression, and it is done in the diffuser part. The air is further compressed in the compressor to a pressure of 3 to 4 bar using a rotary compressor. The compressed air is then made to enter the combustion chamber part, which is a burner section in this case, where fuel is added. The combustion of fuel takes place at sensibly constant pressure, and subsequently temperature rises rapidly. The hot gases then enter the gas turbine
gas turbine
where partial expansion takes place. The power produced is just sufficient to drive the compressor, fuel pump and other auxiliaries which are been used in the turbojet. The exhaust gases from the gas turbine, which are at high pressure than atmosphere, are expanded in a nozzle and a very high velocity jet is produced, which provides a forward motion to the aircraft opposite to the jet reaction is produced. This is how a turbojet is going to work. Now we see some of the advantages. The first advantage is that much simpler in construction, engine vibrations are absent, much higher speeds are possible, maybe around or more than 3000 kilometers per hour is attainable, higher propulsion efficiency at higher speeds, as the speeds goes on increases for the object, the propulsion efficiency will also go on increases. Power supply is uninterrupted and smooth, so we can have a continuous supply of power. Weight to power ratio is superior, as the construction is very simple. High rate of climb is achievable, so altitude of the object can be attained here at very high rate. Requirement of major overhaul is less frequently, that is maintenance required for the object, that is turbojet, is very less. Radio interference is much less. Smaller frontal area, the area in front of the jet is very small. As a result, the force which is opposed in the movement of jet is less, as the frontal area is also less. Fuel can be burned over a large range of mixture strength. So in these kinds of propulsion systems, so variety of mixture strength can be used. Maximum altitude ceiling can be attainable in these cases of propulsion systems. So these are the few advantages which can be obtained or available with respect to turbojet, and there are few disadvantages we can make out here. The first disadvantage is efficiency is less. So as the altitude is lesser, so efficiency will be less, but as the altitude increases, as the speed increases, efficiency reduces. So these devices are meant for high speed propulsion systems only, not for the lower speeds, because the efficiency increases with speed. Life of the unit is comparatively shorter because the construction is very simple, so the weight to power ratio is also very less. So for that reason, comparatively the life of the unit will be very less, as the object or the propulsion system will be moving at very higher speed, so overall life of the unit will be very shorter. Below 550 kilometers per hour becomes rapidly inefficient for turbojets, so more noisy, so the turbojet will make very high noise in the operation. Material required are quite expensive for these kinds of jets, so requires longer strips, as length of the takeoff is too much. So using these kinds of jets, if you want to take off from the land to certain altitudes, the distance required to take off is very large, so longer strips are required for taking off. During takeoff, thrust is very low, so This is one of the another reason why you require longer strips for takeoff, because the thrust is very less during the takeoff period. So moving on to next one, which is a turboprop. So figure shows a turboprop system employed in aircraft. Here the expansion of gases takes place partly in the turbine part and partly in the nozzle. So about 80% expansion takes place in the turbine and 20% in the nozzle. And this is a pictorial representation and this is a line diagram. The power developed by the turbine is consumed in running the compressor. As you know, or as you can observe here, the turbine and compressors are mounted on the same shaft, and you are going to have a propeller at the entrance of the this system, and there is a prop. So this is a fan like structure which is called as a prop. So that's why the name itself is given as a turboprop. And the propeller and jet produced by the nozzle gives forward motion to the aircraft. So the propeller, so prop is a short form of the propeller. So the propeller at the entrance of this turbo jet and the nozzle will provide the propulsion force for the movement of the aircraft. The turboprop overall efficiency is improved by providing the diffuser before the compressor. There will be a diffuser at the entrance of the compressor. The pressure rise takes place in the diffuser due to conversion of kinetic energy of the incoming air here. So part of the pressure rise is taken place in the diffuser. So this type of compression is known as ram effect. It is similar to your turbojet. So there we are also having a diffuser. So diffuser is used to convert kinetic energy of the air into pressure. So the turboprop entitles some of the advantages and disadvantages when compared to turbojet. So we see one by one. So simpler in design and construction. Engine vibrations are absent. High propulsion efficiency at speeds below 600 km per hour. Their efficiency increases as the speed increases, but here at lower speeds we can attain higher efficiencies. Power supply is uninterrupted and smooth. Continuous power supply is available. Low specific weight, weight is very low. Higher rate of climb, so we can reach higher heights using these devices. Requirement of major overhauls is less frequently, so that is overall maintenance or maintenance for these devices are very less. Radio interference is much less, and smaller frontal area you can have. And fuel can be burnt over a large range of mixture strength, and maximum altitude ceiling is also available in this case. And some of the few disadvantages we can observe here, so that is efficiency is less, so because efficiency depends on the speed as well as the altitude, and life is also comparatively shorter because simple in construction and design, more noisy because of the propeller in front of the device, and material required are quite expensive, requires high power for takeoff, and longer strips is also required for these kinds of engines. Moving on to next one, which is a ramjet. So ramjet is also called Athodyde or Lorin or Flying Stove. These are the different names which are there for ramjet. Ramjet engines have the capability to fly at supersonic speeds. So figure shows a schematic diagram of a ramjet engine. So you know about sonic, supersonic and subsonic speeds. So this ramjet is going to fly at supersonic speed. The ramjet engine consists of a diffuser, combustion chamber and nozzle. So this is a diffuser part and this is a combustion chamber and this is a nozzle part. The air enters the ramjet with supersonic speed and it is slowed down to sonic velocity in the supersonic diffuser. The kind of diffuser here used is a supersonic diffuser. The pressure of air is further increased in the subsonic diffuser. increasing the air temperature above the ignition temperature. In the combustion chamber, the fuel is injected through an injection nozzles. The fuel air mixture is then ignited by means of a spark plug, and combustion temperature of the order 2000 Kelvin is attained. The expansion of gases towards the diffuser entrance is restricted by pressure barriers provided here and undergoes expansion, converting pressure into kinetic energy. The high velocity gases leaving the nozzle provides forward thrust to the unit. The best performance of jet engine is obtained for a speed range of 1700 km per hour to 2000 km per hour. Some of the disadvantages we can observe here, advantages and disadvantages. No moving part, as you have seen in your schematic arrangement. Light in weight, wide variety of fuels can be used here. Some disadvantages are it cannot be started of its own because the air has to be reached to its self-ignition temperature of the fuel. Fuel consumption is too large at low and moderate speeds because these are meant for supersonic speeds. Next is pulse jet. So you can observe an animated representation of the pulse jet. A pulse jet engine is an intermittent combustion engine. So the combustion is intermittent, it's not continuous. It operates on a cycle similar to reciprocating engines. It develops thrust by a high velocity jet of exhaust gases without the aid of compressor or a turbine. So there is no compressor and a turbine here, you can observe in the diagram. Figure shows a schematic arrangement of pulse jet propulsion unit. The incoming air is compressed by ram effect in the diffuser section and the grid passages, which are opened and closed by V-shaped non-return valves. The fuel is injected in the combustion chamber by fuel injectors. The combustion is then initiated by a spark plug, you can notice in the diagram. As a result of combustion, the temperature and pressure of the combustion products increases. Because the combustion pressure is higher than the ram pressure, the non-return valve gets closed and consequently, these are the non-return valves, consequently hot gases flow out of the tailpipe. This is a tailpipe of the pulse jet engine with high velocity, and the chamber falls and high pressure air in the diffuser forces the valve to open and the fresh air is admitted for the combustion during the new cycle, and the hot gases which are coming out of the tailpipe will make the engine to or the jet to move in the opposite direction to the flow of exhaust gases. So some of the advantages observed here is simple in construction, well adapted to pilotless aircrafts. These are well adapted for pilotless aircrafts. So these are capable of producing static thrust. Static means instantaneously thrust can be generated, and thrust is in excess of drag at much low speeds. Some of the disadvantages. So the construction is very expensive, high intensity of noise, severe vibration is produced here, high rate of fuel consumption, low thermodynamic efficiency, intermittent combustion, combustion is not continuous, operating altitude is limited by air density, and serious limitations to mechanical valve arrangements are there because you are going to use a non-return valve at the entrance of the combustion chamber. So this is all about your pulse jet. And next one is rocket engine. So we discuss rocket engine, how it is going to work. Similar to jet propulsion, the thrust required for rocket propulsion is produced by high velocity of jet of gases passing through the nozzle. In the rocket engine, the fuel and oxidizer both are combined in a propelling body. So there are some classifications for rocket engines. So according to type of propellant and number of motors you are going to use. So according to propellant, we have solid and liquid propellant. According to number of motors, we have single stage and multi stage. So figure shows a simple single stage liquid propellant rocket. So we can have one more figure. So it is exactly same as of a rocket which can be seen in our life. It consists of a fuel tank. A fuel tank will be there, a oxidizing tank. Two pumps are there, one is for fuel tank, another for oxidizing tank. A steam turbine and a combustion chamber will be there. The fuel tank contains alcohol and oxidizing tank contains liquid oxygen. The fuel and oxidizer are supplied by the pumps to the combustion chamber, where the fuel is ignited by electrical means, that is either maybe using a spark plug. The pumps are driven with the help of a steam turbine. The purpose of using a steam turbine is to supply required power or energy to drive the pumps and valves or other mechanical means. The products of combustion are discharged from the combustion chamber through the nozzle, so the rocket can move in the opposite direction to the discharged product from the nozzle. So there are some requirements of ideal rocket propellant. So high heat value, the propellant used should have a higher heating value, the amount of heat release should be very high. Reliable smooth ignition, so the ignition should be very smooth and reliable. Stability and ease of handling and storing, so the propellant used should be easily handleable as well as easy to store. So non-toxic as well as corrosiveness should be very less for the propellants used in rocket engines. Highest possible density so that it occupies less space. So if the density is high, the space required for storing the fuel and oxidants are very less, that is for the propellants. As the size is less, the overall size of the rocket will also be very less. Some of the applications of rockets we can see here, long range artilleries. So these are used in long range artilleries, lethal weapons, signaling and firework displays, jet assisted takeoffs, so research work, satellites, spaceships. So these are the few areas where we can see the applications of rocket engines. And this is the end of the session on jet propulsion. Thank you very much. Please do subscribe to my channel, BR Mech Academy.